हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अवर न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 2, एम्बेडेड आईओटी डिवाइसेस। ओके, सो वी ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दी चैप्टर नंबर 1, विच इज़ अ इंट्रोडक्शन टू आईओटी। ओके, सो इन चैप्टर नंबर 1 वी डिस्कस अबाउट दी बेसिक ऑफ आईओटी, व्हाट इज़ आईओटी एंड हाउ दिस आईओटी हेल्प दी पीपल एंड हाउ वी कैन यूज़ दी आईओटी एट वेरियस प्लेसेस। ओके, सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर वी विल सी दी एम्बेडेड आईओटी डिवाइसेस। ओके, सो व्हाट इज़ मीनिंग ऑफ एम्बेडेड? Embedded is a type of things that the we make together something that many electronic component are placed in one chip for any particular purpose. Okay, so any one purpose we to make together many components like microcontroller and storage device, then something network related devices. Okay, so we embedded such a system that we can achieve our desired thing. Okay, so in this particular lecture, what will you see? Content of this chapter is the first is the sensors. So in this particular section, we will see the what are the type of sensors, what kind of sensors are there in IoT. Then we have smart objects. Then IoT system building blocks. What are the building blocks for the IoT system? Then we study most important topic of IoT is the Arduino Raspberry Pi. Okay, so Arduino is very important point. Then we studied about the Raspberry Pi interface, Raspberry Pi with Python. Okay, so if you don't know about Python, then don't worry, I will make easier for you how we can use the Raspberry Pi with Python. Okay, so don't worry about it that the we doesn't know what is Python and what is Raspberry Pi. So step by step all the things are get open, and when you properly studied it, you feel that it is a very good thing. Okay, so implementation of IoT with the edge devices, reading sensor data and transmit to the cloud. Okay, so controlling device through the cloud using mobile application and web application, then IoT gateways. Okay, so these are the 11 topics that we are going to study in this chapter number 2. Okay, so let's get start. So first thing is the sensors. Okay, so sensor converts a physical quantity into a corresponding voltage. Sensor is a device that when exposed to physical phenomena like a temperature, displacement, force, etc., produces a proportional output signal like electrical, mechanical or a magnetic signal. Okay, so sensor basically convert the physical quantity into the corresponding voltage. Okay, so sensor is a type of transducer. Okay, so a transducer simply converts one form of signal into another form. So sensor also convert a physical quantity into the corresponding electrical quantity. Okay, so the term transducer is often used synonymously with the sensors. Okay, so sensor is a device that respond to a change in the physical phenomena. On the other hand, transducer is a device that converts one form of energy into another form of energy. So sensors are a transducer when they sense one form of input and the output is different form of energy. Okay, so sensors can also be classified as a passive or active. So what are the passive sensors? So passive sensors, the power required to produce the output is provided by the sensed physical phenomena itself, whereas active sensors require external power source. Okay, so these are the types of what is a passive sensor. Sorry, this book makes some mistake that in passive sensor we need a external power, but in active sensor we doesn't require any external power. Okay, so this is the mistake. So keep in mind that the active sensor does not require any external power. Active sensor inherently have a power that it can produce as electric signal. Okay, so in embedded system, sensor and actuators are used for controlling the system. Sensor are connected to the input port, actuators are connected to the output port. Okay, so sensor captures the changes in the environmental variable, middle system process the information, actuators are changed according to the input variable, it display the output. Okay, so example of control is air conditioner system. It controls the room temperature to specified limit. Okay, so when you already aware of this thing that when your air conditioner reach at the temperature which you preset, then at that time your outside unit of air conditioner stop working. Okay, and only inside unit is in working condition, and inside unit fan is only working there. Okay, so when the again when room temperature start increase, at that time this sensor sense the room temperature and give the command to the relay that now outside unit should be start to again cool the room. Okay, so this is how we embedded the one system that work automatically. Okay, so there is no any human intervention is needed. Okay, so then deflection. What is deflection? A signal produces some physical effect closely related to the measured quantity and transduced to the observable. Okay, so then what is null? The signal produced by the sensor is counterate to minimize the deflection. That opposing effect necessary to maintain a zero deflection should be proportional to the signal measurement. Okay, so here output is usually electrical quantity and measurement is a physical quantity. So property or condition which is to be measured. Okay, so a sensor is a device that respond to a physical stimulus and measures the physical stimulus quantity and converts it into the signal, usually electrical, and which can be represented by the observer or by instrument. Okay, so sensor can be very small and itself can be a trackable devices, and the sensor itself is not connected, is not part of IoT or WSN value chain. Okay, so specification of sensor accuracy, error between the result of measurement and the true value being measured. Okay, so what is error? What is accuracy? Accuracy is the error between the result of measured and the true value being measured. Okay, so some specification of sensors are there. See, first is accuracy, then second is the resolution. Okay, so the smallest increment of measure that device can make is called the resolution of that sensor. Sensitivity is the ratio between the change in the output signal to the small change in the input physical signal. Slope of the input output fit the line. Okay, so fourth one is a repeatability or precision. The ability of sensor to output the same value for the same input over a number of trials. Fifth one is a bandwidth, the frequency range between the lower and upper cutoff frequency within which sensor transfer function is a constant gain or linear. Okay, so these are some basic things, or we can say some characteristics of the sensor. So now what type of sensor we use in the IoT application. So type of sensor, first is a mechanical sensor. Any suitable mechanical or electrical switch may be adopted, but because a certain amount of force is required to operate a mechanical switch, it is common to use a micro switches. Okay, so we use the micro switches. So mechanical sensors are there. Then pneumatic sensors. So these proximity sensors operate by breaking or disturbing an airflow. Okay, so the pneumatic proximity sensor is an example or a contact type sensor, and this cannot be used where light components may be blown away. Okay, so pneumatic sensor are generally a proximity sensor, and proximity sensor is disturbed when light is fall on it. Okay, so then third type of sensor is optical sensor. So in this simplest form, optical proximity sensor operate by breaking a light beam which falls on a light sensitive device such as a photosensor. Okay, so these are the example of non-contact sensors. Care must be exercised with the lighting environment of this sensor. For example, optical sensor can be blinded by flashes from arc welding process, airborne dust or smoke clouds maybe. So this creates some problem for the optical sensor. Okay, so we have to take care of this. Then electrical proximity sensors may be contact or non-contact type. Simple contact sensor operate by making the sensor and the component complete an electrical circuit, and non-contact electrical proximity sensors rely on the electrical principles of the either induction or detecting metals or capacitance of detecting non-metal as well. Okay, so then range sensing. So if we want to sense the range, then there are some range sensing sensor also there. Okay, so so this is one figure that this detect the temperature sensor detects the heat, then it will send this detect signal to the control center. Okay, and control center sends command to the sprinkle, and the sprinkle turn on and puts out the flame. Okay, so this is how we make the sensor for the quenching the arc. Okay, quenching the fire. Okay, the selection of proper actuator is more complicated than the selection of the sensor. Okay, so we have to properly select the actuator, primarily due to their effect on a dynamic behavior of the overall system. Furthermore, the selection of actuator dominates the power needs and the coupling mechanism of the entire system. In typical IoT system, a sensor may collect information and route to a control center where a decision is made and corresponding command is sent back to an actuator in response to the sensed input. Okay, so this is how we use some sensors in the IoT device. In next lecture we will see the smart object. Okay, so up to now, if you have any kind of query, then you can comment it down. Thank you.